Jocelyn Burnett, the famous contralto, is spending a few days in Kensington on her return from her maritime concert tour. She is the guest of Mr. and Mrs. Bromley of the Beeches. "Now, if I can get there in time," said Jordan emphatically. Jordan got to Kensington, put Dan in a livery stable, and inquired the way to the Beeches. He felt rather nervous when he found it. It was such a stately, imposing place, set back from the street in an emerald-green seclusion of beautiful grounds. "Fancy me stalking up to that front door and asking for Miss Jocelyn Burnett," grinned Jordan sheepishly. "Maybe they'll tell me to go around to the back and inquire for the cook. But you're going just the same, Jordan Sloane, and no skulking. March right up now. Think of Auntie Nan, and don't let style down you." A pert-looking maid answered Jordan's ring and stared at him when he asked for Miss Burnett. "I don't think you can see her," she said shortly, scanning his country cut of hair and clothes rather superciliously. "What is your business with her?" The maid's scorn roused Jordan's dander, as he would have expressed it. "I'll tell her that when I see her," he retorted coolly. "Just you tell her that I've a message for her from Auntie Nan Morrison of Gull Point Farm, Avonlea. If she ain't forgot, that'll fetch her. You might as well hurry up, if you please. I've not overly too much time." The pert maid decided to be civil at last, and invited Jordan to enter. But she left him standing in the hall while she went in search of Miss Burnett. Jordan gazed about him in amazement. He had never been in a place like this before. The hall was wonderful enough, and through the open doors on either hand stretched vistas of lovely rooms that, to Jordan's eyes, looked like those of a palace. "Gee whiz! How do they ever move around without knocking things over?" Then Jocelyn Burnett came, and Jordan forgot everything else. This tall, beautiful woman, in her silken draperies, with a face like nothing Jordan had ever seen or even dreamed about. Could this be Auntie Nan's little Jocelyn? Jordan's round, freckled countenance grew crimson. He felt horribly tongue-tied and embarrassed. What could he say to her? How could he say it?